Great Indian Railway, lifeblood of the world's most populous democracy. And this vast network, by the very nature of its history, topography, and the culture of its railways, is home to some extraordinary little trains.
It has to be the Shangri-La of steam in southern India.
The Nilgiri Mountain Railway, one of the great feats of engineering in Indian railway history. It uses over 200 bridges, 13 tunnels, to rise a grade of 1 in 12, which is extraordinary in railway history, to get up over 2,000 metres to the beautiful British Hill Station of Uti.
Because this is where the Nilgiri Mountain Railway's most famous feature, the Rack and Pinion, actually starts and takes us up to Uti. But in the process, the first three or four teeth are very well worn because it's not quite in alignment. And then it'll jerk into alignment, and away we'll go.
Construction was completed by the British at great expense in 1908. In 2005, the railway was added to the UNESCO World Heritage List.
But it's interesting, essentially, you would expect a railway like this to have been built to service the tea industry. But as far as we're led to believe, it was actually built primarily as a tourist railway.
Well, to service the British in their golden era in the India, and they wanted to have these hill stations for their summer breaks from the heat on the plains. So Shimla above Delhi, Darjeeling above the plains near Assam, and this beautiful, hidden, superb, surreal railway up to Uti in southern India.
It's completely charming, isn't it?
It is charming, authentic. Engineering-wise, very challenging for the young engineers when 2 years ago they had 4 days of rain, bridges knocked out, big rocks down, and yet soon enough they had it going again. Had all the walls back in place, and every morning they checked the track just as well.
Reason for the continued success of the railway and the survival of steam on the line can be found inside the vast Golden Rock Railway Workshops near Trichy, some 300 kilometres from Uti.
But it is a non-profit accounting system.
Tell me about the steam operation within the workshop.
We asked Swiss manufacturers whether they can make these locos for us. So they quoted more than 12 crores per loco.
$2 million
roughly. But now we have made this.
Sorry, what's that?
That's the workshop siren.
1 o'clock.
And what's that mean?
It means the staff have to come back to work.
Lunch is over.
Yeah, lunch is over. And we made that loco at 1/4 of the cost.
One-fourth.
One-fourth.
Well, you can export locos to Switzerland.
Yes, we can export to Switzerland.
Starting from scratch, these locomotives are manufactured as per the specifications required for the grueling Uti escarpment. With one notable addition, modern diesel engines are built into the bunker area to assist and support the reliability of these little locos.
It's all here. 6,000 people work here at this jewel of a set of workshops, which most Australian and British railway buffs would love to spend half a day in and would come away in amazement.
The Uti train is one of India's cultural icons. It's a marvel of railway engineering. And without a doubt, it makes for one of the great railway journeys of the world.
And so our train rolls onto Uti. Perched high in the mountains, this one-time colonial outpost retains many of the famous British-era institutions. Like the Uti Club, a great place to find yourself at the end of a hard day's travel.
What year did the club actually establish?
1842. So that makes us 171 years old now. And the building is 191 years old. Yes. Great history, and I would like to very proudly tell you that the game of snooker was invented in this club.
I see.
By Sir Neville Chamberlain.
Fantastic.
I think we ought to challenge India
to a game of snooker.
To a game of snooker, don't you think? Australia versus India.
We
at the
have
snooker table.
India has produced world-class players, and they are ruling the world championship currently.
Mm. And we won't mention the subject of cricket currently either.
Yes, I mean
it's beautiful.
Get stoked! I got the colour straight on, but the idea is to pot it, you know.
Is it going to affect my game knowing that this is where snooker was invented?
Probably.
And like the Uti train, Southern India's ultimate luxury express, the Golden Chariot, has an amazing story to tell. India is a country of such diversity, and its railways are no exceptions.